हेलो मेरे स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू केमिस्ट्री क्लास बेटा। सो इन टुडेज़ क्लास फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ कॉम्पिटेटिव पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द साइनाइड्स एंड आइसोसाइनाइड्स। ए कंप्लीट रिवीजन आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू बेटा। सो इन दैट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट विथ नॉमेनक्लेचर। नाना फर्स्ट सपोज द कंपाउंड इज नथिंग बट CH3 बॉन्डेड टू CN। सो वॉट विल बी इट्स कॉमन नेम बेटा? द कॉमन नेम इज नथिंग बट सिंपली वी कैन से दैट methyl cyanide, and also we can write another common name, that is nothing but acetonitrile. This is very important for you, acetonitrile. And what will be its IUPAC name? So how to write this IUPAC name beta? So yahan par carbon number 1, and we can say this is nothing but carbon number 2. So 2 carbon means simply we can say the root word is nothing but 8. Between two carbon there is a single bond, means we have to say that the primary suffix is nothing but ethane. And we can say very well, aapko maalum beta, cyanides, one more another name is nothing but we have to say that nitriles. So we have to say that ethane nitrile, and also we can say that acetonitrile. We can write it in both the places beta. Good. Next, another compound I am going to be write here, CH3 bonded to CH2, CH2 bonded to CN. Here two carbons are there, so two carbons in the form of alkyl side chain, that is nothing but ethyl. So ethyl group connected to CN, simply we can say that ethyl cyanide. So for this ethyl cyanide, I am going to write the IUPAC name beta, carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3. So simply what we can say, its IUPAC name is nothing but propane nitrile. Propane nitrite. Yes, next I am going to consider another compound, CH3 bonded to CH2. Again I am going to consider another CH2, and you suppose it was connected to CN. For this the IUPAC common name is nothing but, so here three carbons are there, simply we can say this is nothing but N-propyl. N-propyl group connected to what but a CN, so this is nothing but N-propyl cyanide. So what is its IUPAC name? So this is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3, carbon number 4. Total 4 carbons are here, simply we can say that butane, and butane connected to N, it indicates what beta? Nitrile. Good. Next go for, yes this is the normal propyl, but now normal propyl I want to convert into isoform beta. So isoform ek aise likh sakte, CH3 bond CH, and you suppose below plane CH3. And you suppose it connected to what beta? CN. So yahan par bhi three carbon hai beta, but this is in the form of what? Okay, isoform. So simply we can say that its compound common name is called isopropyl cyanide, but its IUPAC name will be, functional group carbon is 1, and you suppose adjacent is denote as 2 beta, and you denote as this is nothing but 3. So 2 methyl propane nitrile. So this side chain is nothing but methyl. So we can say 2 methyl, remaining root word contain 3, that is nothing but propane, and it connected to the functional group is nothing but nitrile. 2 methyl propane nitrile. Okay beta, good. Next, another form I am going to be right here, CH2 double bond CH, it bonded to CN. Simply we can say that vinyl cyanide, but it contains one more common name, very important. Yes, both we can write beta. So this is nothing but vinyl cyanide, and also we can write another common name. All these are the common name, middle column beta. Yes, one more name is nothing but we have to say that acrylonitrile. Try to be focused on this name only beta, acrylonitrile. This is called acryl carbon, or we can say allylic carbon. If allylic carbon is going to be act as CN, this is called acrylonitrile. IUPAC name, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. So we can say root word is nothing but probe beta, and there is a double bond after second position, so we can say that 2-ene, probe 2-ene, and first carbon connected to N, so we can say that is nothing but 1-nitrile, probe 2-ene, 1-nitrile, or we can say 2-propene-nitrile. Next beta, yes I am going to write here another example. Simply I have taken here C6H5, nothing but benzene ring or phenyl ring, you suppose connected to CN. So phenyl cyanide, yes we can write here phenyl cyanide. Okay na beta, बट वन मोर आईपैक नेम एंड आल्सो वी कैन से कॉमन नेम, दो भी सेम लिख सकते हैं, दैट इज नथिंग बट बेंजीन कनेक्टेड कार्बन इज बेंजो, बेंजो नाइट्राइल, इट इज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बेंजो नाइट्राइल. So try to focus on three words, beta. What is mean by benzonitrile? What is mean by acrylonitrile? What is mean by acetonitrile? Remaining सारे names तुम easy remember कर सकते हो. But तीन focus करना पड़ेगा. Acetonitrile CH3CN. Acrylonitrile CH2 double bond CH bonded to CN. Benzonitrile benzene bonded to CN. So phenyl cyanide is benzonitrile. Methyl cyanide is acetonitrile. Vinyl cyanide is acrylonitrile. Try to focus on three names. They are very important for you. Okay? Yes, these are the few unselected and very important compounds of cyanides, their respective common names and their respective IUPAC names. Now let us consider two to three examples of isocyanides beta. CH3 bonded to isocyanide, or we can say isonitrile, and also we can say carbyl amines. So the formula is nothing but CH3 bonded to NC. But in case of cyanides, between carbon to nitrogen, three covalent bonds are there. But in case of isocyanides, between carbon to nitrogen, two will be covalent and one more is nothing but arrow mark, nothing but coordinate covalent bond. Samjhe beta? Good. So what is its common name? So this is nothing but methyl group. Yes, I have written here. So yahan par CN hai ki NC hai beta? CN का मीनिंग साइनाइड और NC का मीनिंग व्हाट, हाउ टू से दैट, आइसोसाइनाइड, मिथाइल आइसोसाइनाइड. सर व्हाट इज इट्स आईयूपैक नेम, हाउ टू रीड द आईयूपैक नेम, ओके सिंपली हाउ टू से दैट दिस इज नथिंग बट मिथाइल ग्रुप, यस आई एम गोइंग टू बी राइट, यस एंड लिसन केयरफुली, आइसोसाइनाइड्स और वी कैन से वन मोर नेम इज नथिंग बट आइसोनाइट्राइल्स एंड आल्सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू अनदर नेम carbyl amines. So this is nothing but methyl carbyl amine. So its IUPAC name is nothing but methyl carbyl amine. Now I want to consider another example. CH3 bond CH2, CH2 bonded to N, two are covalent, one more is coordinate covalent, NC. Okay, so this is nothing but what, ethyl isocyanide. Its compound name is nothing but ethyl isocyanide. So for this ethyl isocyanate, what is its common IUPAC name beta here? So this is nothing but, above one is nothing but methyl carbyl amine, and what about this beta? This is nothing but ethyl carbyl amine. Ethyl carbyl amine. And you should be remember one thing, cyanides and isocyanides both are nothing but functional isomers. For suppose example CH3CN and CH3NC, both are nothing but the functionally isomers to each other. So cyanides and isocyanides are examples of what beta? Functional isomers. Good. So this is nothing but ethyl carbyl amine. Yes, I have written there common name and IUPAC name. Let me consider one more aromatic compound. Yes, first of all I want to be consider here benzene ring, and also we can say that phenyl. You suppose it was connected to, okay now NC. What is the common name? Phenyl isocyanide. So its common name is nothing but phenyl isocyanide. And what is its IUPAC name? So IUPAC name, again same thing, we can say that phenyl carbyl amine. Phenyl carbyl amine. Okay beta? So this is the story about the nomenclature of cyanides and isocyanides along with their common names and IUPAC names. Okay beta? Now I am going to discuss about the preparations of cyanides and isocyanides. Yes, in that preparations, number one. Number one is by using alkyl halides. And also we can say that from alkyl halides. Simply I am going to be right here from RX. So from alkyl halides, how to prepare the cyanides and isocyanides? Yes. So let me consider one example directly. Alkyl halide RX. Let me consider ethyl chloride. C2H5Cl, and you suppose ethyl chloride, now it undergo reaction with alcoholic KCN, alcoholic potassium cyanide. So alkyl halide, that is nothing but ethyl chloride, it upon reaction with alcoholic KCN, alcoholic potassium cyanide. So here K contain charge plus, and in Cn minus. Okay, now minus charge was present upon C, not upon N. In case of alcoholic KCl, which is the nucleophilic center, either nitrogen or carbon. Carbon is nothing but nucleophilic center. Try to remember, okay? Because of KCN is nothing but which type of compound beta? Ionic compound. Be focused. In ACN, KCN, you can consider as a wish beta. So ethyl, again, ethyl charge is nothing but plus. It goes to be commands with CN minus. So the product is nothing but C2H5CN. You have to be give the connection with C, not with N. Of course, ethyl isocyanate is also possible, but that is minor. So in case of alcoholic KCN, so ethyl chloride on reaction with alcoholic KCN, it gives the product is nothing but ethyl cyanide. And the byproduct is nothing but K combines with Cl and goes to be eliminated in the form of what beta KCl. Along with ethyl cyanide in this reaction, you are going to get the ethyl isocyanide, but that is as a major product because of, in case of KCl, in case of ionic compounds, C contain charge minus, we have to give the link through C only, not through N beta. Okay, good. Another example I want to consider from this alkyl chloride category, that is nothing but ethyl chloride. You suppose now it undergo reaction with alcoholic AgCl. Which compound beta? Alcoholic AgCl. So what about here alcoholic KCN? Alcoholic KCN is nothing but what beta? Ionic compound, but yahan par alcoholic AgCn, it is a covalent compound. Try to be focused. But again in that covalent compound is a bond breaking Ag plus combines with Cl and goes to be eliminated in the form of what beta? AgCl. Remaining is what na? Ag plus to gaya, remaining is Cn minus, but here minus present upon nitrogen. So in case of AgCn or CuCn, in such covalent species, nitrogen should contain negative charge. Nitrogen should be act as nucleophilic center that should be connected to ethyl group. So the product is what beta? C2H5 bonded to NC. So ethyl chloride on reaction with alcoholic KCN, cyanide is major product, and ethyl chloride on reaction with alcoholic AgCN, it gives the product is nothing but isocyanide is major. So in case of alcoholic KCN, cyanides are major. In case of alcoholic AgCN, isocyanides are major. Because of, in case of KCN, C is the nucleophilic center, so cyanide is major. In case of alcoholic AgCN, N is nucleophilic center, so isocyanides are major. I hope you understand. Second method of preparation, that is nothing but the carbylamine reaction. In the last class also, I have told you beta. What is the reaction? Carbylamine reaction. And also we can say that isocyanide test. Carbylamine reaction, and also what we are saying beta, isocyanide test. Yeah, what is mean by carbylamine reaction or isocyanide test? It is a test applicable only for primary amines, maybe aliphatic, maybe aromatic beta. Okay, let me consider first of all aliphatic amine. First, suppose directly I am going to write that CH3NH2 aliphatic primary amine. We can say simply methylamine. In place of CH3, if you want, you can write ethyl. In place of CH3, if you want, you can write benzene also. As you wish. Good. So, aliphatic primary amine upon heating with chloroform. Heating with chloroform takes place, okay. But here we have to use one of the suitable reagents. That is nothing but what beta? Alcoholic KOH, potassium hydroxide. Which type of potassium hydroxide? Alcoholic nature, potassium hydroxide we have to be take here. But for the removal of 3 chlorine, we require 3 potassiums. That means we have to be consider 3 moles of KOH. So once again, maybe aliphatic primary or maybe aromatic primary. Primary amines upon heating with chloroform ion, alcoholic KOH, it forms the isocyanides with the liberation of foul smell and very dangerous smell. So you are getting cyanides, isocyanides are. Isocyanide, that is nothing but NC, but here the alkyl group is methyl, so we can say methyl isocyanide. So what is the smell of isocyanide beta? Foul smell isocyanides you are getting here. Foul smell. And 3 moles of K plus combines with 3Cl and goes to be eliminated in the form of 3 moles of KCl. And remaining here 3 oxygens are there, simply we can eliminate in the form of 3 moles of water molecule. Clear beta? So methylamine gives methyl isocyanide, ethylamine gives ethyl isocyanide, phenylamine gives nothing but aniline gives, okay, now phenyl isocyanide. Whatever that may be, finally here you are going to get the foul smell reaction, and within the fraction of second may you can identify the foul smell beta. Okay, good. So try to think of the applications. Methylamine gives methyl isocyanide, and okay, now aniline gives phenyl isocyanide. Try to think, nana, aliphatic and aromatic, do ko bhi likh sakte, but they should be in primary nature. Yes, third preparation I am going to give you. Using, so in the preparation of cyanides and isocyanides, third method we are discussing beta. Using amides and Hinzberg reagent, very very important. Using amides and Hinzberg reagent, directly I am going to show the reaction beta. Okay, using amides, let me consider one amide formula. R bonded to C double bond O, C double bond O bonded to NH2. So this is the formula of acid amide, and simply we can select amide. Amides upon reaction with Hinzberg reagent. So what is the formula of Hinzberg reagent beta? Benzene sulfonyl chloride. So here Cl connected to S, S double bond O, double bond O. Otherwise simply we can write that what beta? SO2, it connected to benzene. So benzene sulfonyl chloride, so this is nothing but Hinzberg reagent. Here reaction will be takes place in presence of one catalytic base, that is nothing but pyridine. Okay beta, yeah, so amides upon reaction with Hinzberg reagent in presence of pyridine, so what will be the expected product? Listen carefully, one hint I want to tell you. Amides upon reaction with Hinzberg reagent, which mechanism will be takes place? A, hydrogenation, B, dehydrogenation, C, hydration, D, dehydration. So answer is nothing but dehydration. When amides reacts with Hinzberg reagent, automatically amides will undergo dehydration, nothing but from that amides we have to be eliminate the water molecule H2NO, it goes to be eliminated. Remaining is RCN. Means what is the expected product beta? Cyanides are the expected products here. Yes, what we eliminated here? H2NO. Of course amides undergo dehydration, but here you are not getting the product is water, because of that released water, that removed water molecule from the amide. Now again in that water H plus is there, that combines Cl minus and goes to be eliminated in the form of HCl. So water say H plus to gaya beta, remaining is OH minus. Already benzene contain SO2, but we have SO3. So we have OH na beta, SO given to SO2, SO2 become SO3, again H is there. So benzene SO2 reacts with OH minus from water molecule, so we are going to get the product is nothing but benzene bonded to SO3H. This is called benzene sulfonic acid. This is your byproduct, benzene sulfonic acid. Okay, ab to tum application to bhi dena padega. Try to think about the applications beta. First, suppose R replaced by CH3, what is the product? Methyl isocyanide. Yes, I am going to write two question. R replaced by CH3, amide name is called acetamide. Yes, sir, no, beta. Very important. Focus on that word only. Up to know so many times I have told you. So this is nothing but what beta? Acetamide. Acetamide upon reaction with HR in presence of pyridine. So definitely, okay, R acetamide converted into RCN. R place me kya hai beta? CH3. So the expected product is nothing but CH3CN. So acetamide changes into acetonitrile, and also we can say that methyl cyanide. Yes, one more question I want to write here. Benzene bonded to C double bond O, C double bond O bonded to NH2. What is the name of this compound? Benzamide. Yes, amide example acetamide. One more example is benzamide. So amide changes into RCN, acetamide changes into CH3CN, and benzamide changes into same thing beta, benzene bonded to CN. So common product is nothing but cyanide, and this is nothing but methyl cyanide, and this is nothing but phenyl cyanide. And also we can say that acetamide gives acetonitrile, benzamide gives benzonitrile. That's why I have told you focus on these three words. Okay beta, Okay. Next, fourth method of preparation. Right. Method number four in the preparations of cyanides and isocyanides. So for using aldoxanes. Using aldoxanes and AC2O, nothing but acetic anhydride. Okay. Let me write first of all aldoxane formula. Nothing but when aldehydes reacts with hydroxyl amine, they form salt beta oxane. So aldehyde formula is nothing but RCHO undergo reaction with hydroxyl amine NH2OH. After loss of water molecule we will get here a double bond N connected to OH. See double bond NOH, this is called oxane, but this oxane coming from aldehyde, so simply we can say this is nothing but aldoxane. It undergo reaction with acetic anhydride. What is the formula of acetic anhydride? CH3 bonded to C double bond O, second choice O beta, acetic anhydride. So यहाँ पर भी मैं आपको एक बहुत ज़रा ओके ना एक वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लिस्ट में यहाँ पर बताना चाहता, सो ट्राई टू बी फोकस बेटा. Amides upon reaction with Hinsberg reagent, from that amides we remove water molecule. Nothing but I told you amide undergo dehydration. Here also same thing. When aldoxanes undergo reaction with acetic anhydride, again aldoxane undergo dehydration, means remove H and remove OH. Remaining, after removal of water molecule, double bond become triple bond RCN. So R bonded to C, C triple bond N. So here also the major product is nothing but what beta? Cyanide. Remaining, so तुमने क्या remove किया? H and OH, we remove water molecule ना बेटा. So from that aldoxane, we are removing the water molecule. That water molecule, that H2O combines with acetic anhydride. Here two acyl groups are there. That goes to be eliminated in the form of 2 moles of acetic acid. 2 moles of acetic acid. This is the byproduct here. So I want to write here one question. Answer फटाफट बोल दीजिए बेटा. Yes, in place of R, I want to write CH3. CH3 bonded to CH. Again, double bond N. N bonded to OH. So this is also oxane, but looking like CH3CHO. So we can say coming from acetaldehyde. And also we have to say that this is nothing but acetaldoxane. So acetaldoxane, again same thing. On reaction with what beta? Acetic anhydride, AC2O. And it eliminate how many water? Na? 2 moles of water. Is it going to eliminate the 2 moles of acetic acid after loss of H2OH? So in place of R, we have to be right CH3. So CH3 bonded to C triple bond CN. Samajh gaye beta clearly? So acetaldoxane, it gives acetonitrile. And also we can say that methyl cyanide. Yes, in place of CH3, agar benzene likhe samjho, we can say that benzaldoxane. Yes, in place of CH3 benzene, that is nothing but benzonitrile. So aldoxane gives alkyl cyanide, acetaldoxane gives acetonitrile, benzaldoxane gives benzonitrile. Okay beta, good. Next, another method of preparation I want to show you. Again I want to consider aldoxane. Aldoxane formula, R bonded to CH, CH double bond N, N bonded to OH. So this is nothing but what beta? Aldoxane. Aldoxanes undergo heating, or upon heating with, heating takes place by using phosphorus pentoxide, P2O5. It also going to be act as dehydrating agent. In place of P2O5, here also you can use another dehydrating agent, that is nothing but POCl3. That means phosphonyl chloride. Both they have the function removal of water molecule. So H and OH ko remove kijiye. So removal of H2O, that is the function of P2O5 and POCl3. After loss of H and OH, remaining R bonded to C is a double bond, become triple bond. R bonded to C, triple bond N. Nothing but again here we are getting the product is nothing but cyanide. Again acetone oxygen gives acetonitrile and benzoyl oxygen gives what beta? Benzonitrile. Both are same by using acetic anhydride and also by using P2O5 and also by using POCl3. By using any one reagent, we can convert the all oxams into respective cyanides. Go for it. Next, Nana, another method of preparation. Let me consider one example of Grignard reagent or MGX. First, suppose the example is CH3MgCl, means methyl, magnesium, chloride. In place of CH3, you can write benzene also, phenyl, magnesium, chloride, whatever that means. So, methyl, magnesium, chloride, it is an example of ZR, means Grignard reagent. It undergo reaction with Cl bond Cn. Of course, I hope you don't know the name of this compound. Try to be remember. So this is nothing but we have to say that cyanogen chloride. What is the name of this compound, beta? Cyanogen chloride. Cl. Cyanogen Cl chloride. Now we have to be eliminate this group MgCl2. And reaction goes to be takes place in presence of ether. Because of Grignard reagent, सारे में क्या यूज करते हैं इथर ना बेटा. So यहाँ पर we have to remove the group is nothing but MgCl2 magnesium chloride. Remaining CH3 and Cl. So the product is nothing but what beta? Acetonitrile. And also we can say the phenyl cyanide. Once again. So methyl magnesium bromide on reaction with cyanogen chloride. Cn bonded to Cl. And in presence of ether, after the loss of MgCl2 group, CH3Cn, nothing but methyl cyanide, that is a product, and also we can say that acetonitrile, as you wish. Okay, so methyl magnesium chloride gives methyl cyanide, phenyl magnesium bromide gives phenyl cyanide, nothing but benzonitrile. Again, we can prepare both aliphatic and aromatic. Okay, beta, good. Last one, final method of preparation from the cyanides and isocyanide topic. First of all, I want to consider one formula, R bonded to CH2, CH2 bonded to NH2. So it is nothing but what beta? One of the example of primary amine because of NH2 group is there. So R bonded to CH2, CH2 bonded to NH2, nothing but a primary amine. It undergo catalytic dehydrogenation, means removal of H2. So which catalytic they have to be used, either copper or silver, no problem. Yes, by using some temperature, either 573 Kelvin, okay, or between, in between the range, we can use beta as you wish. Okay, so primary amines, upon heating with copper, they undergo catalytic dehydrogenation, removal of H2 gas, H2, okay, 2H2, remove easy beta. After dehydrogenation, after loss of all hydrogen, R bonded to Cn. So what is your product beta? Again, you are getting the product is nothing but cyanide. First suppose R plus में CH3 लिखे, you will get the methyl cyanide. R plus में benzene लिखे, you will get the phenyl cyanide. All types we can prepare. So primary amines upon catalytic dehydrogenation, they goes to be formed, the product is nothing but cyanides. So these are the mainly very important, okay, now for your objective part of it all seven types of, okay, preparations of cyanides and isocyanides are over. Next, I'm going to enter into the physical properties of what beta? Cyanides and isocyanides. Physical properties of cyanides and isocyanides. Physical properties में अपन पहले किसके बारे में पढ़ेंगे बोले तो listen, lower alkyl cyanides like methyl cyanide, ethyl cyanide, बस. So lower alkyl cyanides, I want to say that they are nothing but the colorless liquids, and they can be soluble in water because of lower alkyl cyanides means, okay, R group is very small, no more steric repulsions, so it goes to be soluble in water and they are colorless liquids. Okay, lower alkyl cyanide, okay, but try to remember one more thing, lower alkyl isocyanides. lower alkyl isocyanates. Yes, same thing beta, they are also colorless liquids, but they are having the nature volatile nature. So colorless volatile liquids. What about lower alkyl cyanide? Just colorless liquids, not volatile nature. That's why they can soluble in water. But here lower alkyl cyanides, lower alkyl isocyanates, they are colorless volatile liquids due to their volatile nature, due to their steam volatile nature. They can't soluble in water. So simply we can say that insoluble in nature. I mean insoluble in water due to the reason is volatile nature. Okay. Next, one more thing I want to say that higher alkyl cyanides, they having the nature same like aromatic carboxylic acids, like benzoic acid liquid, no beta, aromatic carboxylic acids are crystalline solids. Here also higher alkyl cyanides are, agar bahut zyada se zyada carbon hai samjho, higher alkyl cyanides are crystalline solids, of course colorless only, crystalline solids. Information about the physical nature and solubility clear. Next point about the order I want to tell you. So CN, one is cyanide, one more is nothing but isocyanide. Cyanides are, they are having the smell is nothing but peasant order. Cyanides having the order is peasant order. And what about isocyanides? They are having the smell is nothing but unpleasant order. Cyanides are pleasant in nature and they are having the nature, okay na? Cyanides, they are having the order is nothing but what beta? Pleasant order. Yes, due to their pleasant nature, yes, we have to say that they are less toxic, that means less poisonous in nature. But isocyanides, already I have told you foul smell, that means they are having unpleasant odor, unpleasant means we have to be say that they are more toxic in nature, and also we can say that more poisonous in nature. Next, I want to tell you boiling point ke bare mein discuss karna chahta main yahan par, is about the boiling points and about the dipole moment, symbol is U. So boiling point and dipole moment both are having same relation. So cyanides, they are having more boiling point and more dipole moment as compared to the isocyanides. Next, go for another property I want to show you beta. Yes, in the cyanides and isocyanides, especially I want to say that cyanides are ambidentate nucleophiles. Cyanides are what beta? Ambidentate nucleophiles. Ambidentate nucleophiles. Aapko malum hai na, what is meant by ambidentate nucleophile? The nucleophile with two nucleophilic centers, nothing but two connecting centers. Okay, so they are going to exist as ambidentate nucleophile because of sometimes they can be connected through what beta? C, and they can be connected through what? N. If connected through C, cyanide. If connecting through N, isocyanide. But species is only one, but connecting centers are two. So we have to be say that ambidentate nucleophile, especially in cyanides. R bonded to C triple bond N. Okay, one of the pi bond is unstable nature, easily undergo delocalization. Carbon contains charge plus, nitrogen contains minus due to more electronegativity. So in alkyl cyanides, carbon going to be act as electrophilic center and nitrogen going to be act as nucleophilic center. Means cyanides, they can behave as both electrophile and nucleophiles. Such nature is nothing but what beta? Ambidentate nature. Samajh gaye na clearly? Good. So last time, final, I am going to discuss with you properties of cyanides and isocyanides. Properties of cyanides and isocyanides. Properties of cyanides and what beta? Isocyanides. Number one property about the hydrolysis I want to be discuss first of all. Hydrolysis ke baare mein discuss karenge beta pehle. Okay na? Good. So cyanide general formula is nothing but RCN. it upon hydrolysis may be cyanide or may be isocyanide, any isocyanide, definitely upon hydrolysis you required 2 moles of water molecule. And try to remember, they can be, okay, hydrolysis can be takes place either in acidic or in basic medium. Kaun sa bhi medium mein tum reaction chala sakte. So cyanides upon hydrolysis gives mainly 2 product, CN bond ko break kar dena, remaining is RC. Such RC form converted into carboxylic acid and remaining is nothing but a free N atom is there. Free N atom means not nitrogen beta. Such free N atom goes to be eliminated in the form of ammonia gas. So cyanides upon hydrolysis always gives 2 products. One is carboxylic acid and one more is nothing but ammonia. Ammonia should be very fixed because of free nitrogen, free N atom, that should be eliminated in the form of ammonia, and remaining RC form that should be converted into carboxylic acid. So cyanides upon hydrolysis gives, in acidic or basic medium they forms, especially carboxylic acids, there is a main product, and common and fixed byproduct is nothing but ammonia. In place of RCH3, nothing but methyl cyanide. And also we can say that acetonitrile. So acetonitrile gives acetic acid. One question, CH3CN, nothing but acetonitrile. Acetonitrile upon hydrolysis in acidic or basic medium. So the product is nothing but what beta? Acetic acid and free N atom goes to be eliminated in the form of ammonia. Yes, in place of CH3, okay, acetonitrile gives acetic acid. In place of CH3, we can write benzene, means benzonitrile. Benzonitrile gives benzoic acid, and the byproduct is nothing but ammonia beta. Good. Yes. So in that hydrolysis of cyanide, story was over along with example. Let me consider hydrolysis of isocyanides. Hydrolysis of isocyanides. What is the formula of isocyanide? Isocyanide ka formula, R bonded to NC. It upon hydrolysis by taking 2 moles of H2O. Hydrolysis takes place in acidic and basic medium. So again bond breaking takes place between carbon to nitrogen. Yes, cyanides upon hydrolysis, RC form is there, that converted into carboxylic acid. But here RN form is there, RN converted into amine form. Which amine? Primary amine. Basic is a bit of. In cyanides, N atom is there, that removed in the form of ammonia, but here free C atom is there. C should be changes into, don't expect CO2 gas, she should be changes into formic acid, fix. HCOOH, formic acid. So isocyanides upon hydrolysis in acidic and what beta? Basic medium, they are going to form, the product is primary amine, and one more is nothing but formic acid. Let me consider example. R plus mein main yahan par CH3 likhna chahta. So methyl isocyanide, it gives methyl amine. Yahan par R ke plus mein benzene, phenyl isocyanide gives phenyl amine, nothing but aniline, and the byproduct is nothing but formic acid. So in all the cases, formic acid is common. R plus mein CH3, methyl amine. R plus mein benzene, benzene in H2 means aniline. Like that, you are getting primary amine, may be aliphatic, may be aromatic. Good. So next case here, I want to discuss about the reduction. Reduction of cyanides and isocyanides. Wo story apne yahan par padhenge beta. Yes, of course I have told you in case of preparations of amines, but once again, what I am saying beta is reduction. Reductions of cyanides and isocyanides. So try to remember, already I have told you in the last class my beta. Cyanides upon reduction gives primary amine, isocyanides upon reduction gives secondary amine. Okay, cyanides upon reduction, R bonded to CN, cyanides undergo reduction, 4 moles of H is, okay, 4 moles of hydrogen add karna padega. Cyanides upon reduction, reduction takes place by using lithium aluminium hydride, that means LiAlH4. And also we have to take catalytic hydrogenation, also we can do addition of 2 moles of H2 in place of nickel and platinum or palladium. Anyone. So cyanides upon reduction with lithium aluminium hydride or catalytic hydrogenation, they will form the primary amine out of 4 hydrogen, 2 given to C, 2 given to N, CH2, NH2. So the product is nothing but what beta? R, CH2, NH2 means we are getting primary amine. R plus CH3, methyl cyanide. R plus CH3, ethyl amine. So methyl cyanide gives ethyl amine and phenyl cyanide gives benzyl amine. Try to think application. हमेशा दो थिंक करो बेटा, R में CH3, R replace में CH3, R replace में benzene, R replace में benzene. Try to think in all preparations and properties. Okay, now try to apply the two things. Good. So next one is nothing but I want to tell you another one. So cyanides upon reduction gives primary amines. Now here R bonded to NC, nothing but isocyanides. Isocyanides upon reduction by taking 4 moles of hydrogen atom and by using one reducing agent LaH, lithium aluminium hydride, and also we can use what manner, catalytic hydrogenation. Okay, as you wish. Cyanides upon reduction gives primary amine, isocyanides upon reduction gives secondary amine. So answer is R bonded to NH, NH bonded to CH3. Out of 4 hydrogen, 1 given to central and that becomes NH, and remaining 3 H atoms they have given to C, C becomes CH3. So this is your secondary amine. First suppose R plus may CH3, methyl isocyanide, it gives dimethyl amine. First suppose yahan par phenyl, phenyl isocyanide gives methyl phenyl amine, like that. Okay na, good na. Next one. So cyanides upon reduction gives primary amine, isocyanides upon reduction gives what beta? Secondary amines. Next, third method of preparation is in the last class also already I have told you, but once again revision. Mendes reduction. So what is mean by Mendes reduction? Repeat who about so many times subject to my question. So this is the property for cyanides only, means RCN. Cyanides upon reduction, 2 moles of H2. Reduction takes place by using suitable Mendes reducing agent. Sir, what is Mendes reducing agent? So that is nothing but sodium and C2H5OH. That means sodium plus ethyl alcohol. Sodium plus ethyl alcohol. NaOH plus C2H5OH. This mixture is known as Mendes reducing agent. Good. So cyanides upon reduction with sodium and imprints of what nana? Ethanol. Again same thing, cyanides upon reduction always gives the product is nothing but what beta? Primary amine. Yes, you know the reaction very well. Mendes ka reaction aapko malum beta, but try to remember the Mendes reducing agent. Sodium plus ethyl alcohol. So cyanides upon reduction with sodium and ethyl alcohol, here also they are going to form the product is nothing but what beta? Primary amines. Yeah, now I am going to tell you another property, that is nothing but property number 4. How does cyanides RCN undergo reaction with Grignard reagent? The formula is nothing but RMgX, but to show the variation I am writing here R and R prime. So cyanides upon reaction with Grignard reagent and followed by hydrolysis in acidic medium or no problem, it going to be found the product is ketone. How? So main yahan par aapko mechanism nahi batau beta. Okay, I wish you the mechanism. So cyanides upon reaction with what beta? Grignard reagent. In case of Grignard reagent, metal charge plus, R charge minus, one of the pi bond shifted towards the nitrogen. Nitrogen contain plus and sorry, carbon contain plus and nitrogen contain minus. So opposite species opposite ke upar add karna padega. Yes, R bonded to C. Yes, I am going to be right here. C contains sign positive, positive attacked by negative, nothing but we can say R prime. Yes, after shifting of pi bond, triple bond becomes double bond. Yes, here N is there. Nitrogen carries positive, negative charge attacked by positive, that is nothing but MgX. It is an unstable addition intermediate. So followed by it undergo hydrolysis in acidic medium, no problem. Upon hydrolysis, simply we have to break the double bond. Remaining what will be the product? R bond C, C bond R prime. Yes, I have written here. After breaking of double bond, so do bond ko satisfy karna hai to divalent dena padega. What is the divalent species? Oxygen. So this is your product. The product name is nothing but ketone. And your expected byproduct is MgX, nitrogen connected by 2 hydrogen atom. So we can see the byproduct is called amino magnesium halide. Okay, beta. So cyanides upon reaction with Zr, Grignard reagent, and followed by hydrolysis, they goes to be formed. The product is called ketones. R replaced by CH3, R replaced by CH3. Answer is acetone. Yes, one of the R replaced by CH3, one more R replaced by benzene. That is ultimate acetophenone. Both are replaced by benzene. That is called benzophenone. So like that, acetone, acetophenone, benzophenone, all types of ketones we can prepare by the reaction of cyanide with Grignard reagent and followed by what? Beta hydrolysis. Good. So next method of preparation property I am going to show you here, that is about the oxidation of isocyanide. Isocyanide, let me consider methyl isocyanide. What is the formula of methyl isocyanide? CH3 bond N, N triple bond C. So this is nothing but what? Beta methyl isocyanide. Methyl isocyanide, now you suppose it undergo oxidation with mercuric oxide, HGO, mercuric oxide, not mercurous, Hg contains plus 2 beta. So isocyanides upon oxidation with, mercuric oxide, okay, it going to be formed. The product is oxidation karna padega. Oxygen attacking takes place upon lost carbon. So answer is nothing but CH3 bond N. After attacking of oxygen, triple bond become double bond. Yes, here par kya hai beta? C. C goes to be attacked by oxidation, nothing but O. And free mercury will be there, that goes to be eliminated in the elemental form. Good. So what is the product here? CH3NC, isocyanide. And what about here? Same CH3 group is there, methyl. NCO, and also we can say that N double bond, C double bond, O. Very, very, very important. This is called isocyanate. What about this? Cyanide. Methyl isocyanide upon oxidation with mercuric oxide gives methyl isocyanate. This is called MIC. Means methyl isocyanate. Try to be focused. It is a very dangerous compound. I mean poisonous gas. Good. So next compound I want to tell you, same I want to show you, methyl isocyanide, CH3 bond, N triple bond C, nothing but methyl isocyanide, but now undergo oxidation, here with mercuric oxide, now with ozone. Ozone is also nothing but oxidizing agent, it can also give free oxygen, again it can form same product. So CH3 bonded to N, N double bond, C double bond, O, this is also nothing but MIC, methyl isocyanate, poisonous gas. Remaining, okay, after attacking of O, O3 can be changed into O2 gas. Last and final reaction. I want to consider one of the methylamine, I mean primary amine. It is an example of primary amine. Simply we can say methylamine. You suppose now it undergo reaction with PASGEN. What's the formula? COCl2. Or we can say carbonyl chloride. Carbonyl chloride. And we can say that PASGEN. Formula? COCl2 upon heating. Yes, you know very well, COCl2 is nothing but a very dangerous poisonous gas of chlorine. So its common name is nothing but PASGEN and chemical name is nothing but carbonyl chloride. Primary amine or methyl amine on reaction with PASGEN, take 2 hydrogen, 2 chlorine, they goes to be eliminated in the form of 2 moles of HCl. Remaining CH3 bond NCO, again same like above product, very important. So CH3 bonded to NCO, or we can say N double bond C double bond O. This is your product MIC, methyl isocyanide. Very, very important question. So many times it was repeated in all the competitive exams and also repeated in the exams like KPSC exam, IC exam, maybe repeat for it. So methyl isocyanide, this is also known as Bhopal tragedy gas. So what is the poisonous gas? Okay, now our historical poisonous gas released in Bhopal tragedy, that is nothing but MIC, methyl isocyanate, that was released due to by first reaction, second reaction, third reaction. Which one? Due to this reaction only. So due to which reaction Bhopal tragedy was happened? Due to release of MIC. How that MIC was released? When primary amine or methyl amine, when they undergo reaction with water and a carbonyl chloride, a PASGEN, they release a very dangerous MIC, methyl isocyanate. So this incident was happened in the year is nothing but 1984, 3rd December. 1984 3rd December ओके ना एग्लेनेट ऑफ ओके ना मिडनाइट 12 o'clock ये गैस रिलीज हुआ था बेटा ड्यू टू रिलीज ऑफ दैट गैस सो मेनी मेंबर्स दे वर डैड अप टू नाउ आल्सो सो मेनी पीपल्स दे आर सफरिंग ड्यू टू दैट इंसिडेंट दैट मच ऑफ ओके ना इस एनवायरमेंटल इफेक्ट इंसिडेंट ना कंटामिनेट बहुत ज्यादा हो गया वहां पर सो भोपाल ट्रेजेडी गैस इज ड्यू टू MIC मिथाइल आइसोसाइनेट and due to which reaction pass in with primary amine or methyl amine okay now yes when it was happened 1984 3rd December like that I hope you understand this clearly okay now yes one last question C4H11N bahut hi important question hai C4H11N this is the molecular formula for this molecular formula how many structural isomers are possible How many structural isomers are possible? So for this molecular formula, total 8 structural isomers are possible. 8 structural isomers are possible. Out of 8 structural isomers, we can write 4 primary forms, we can write 3 secondary forms, we can write only 1 tertiary form. So total equal to 8 forms. Already question was repeated. Total isomeric forms for C4H11N. Answer is 8. And also they ask you repeated question, beta. How many possible primary structures for the molecular formula C4H11N? So your answer is nothing but 4. If you want, you can write for fatna. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 nitrogen. So N-butyl amine, isobutyl amine, like that we can write 2-3 forms nana. So total primary forms 4, total secondary forms 3, total tertiary form 1, and total how many structural isomers are there? 8 structural isomers. In that 8, 4 are primary, 3 are secondary, and 1 is nothing but what beta? Tertiary. Try to remember total and try to remember primary also. Okay beta? Good. So this is our last chapter. Organic compounds containing nitrogen. This is the third video class regarding cyanides and isocyanides, and first video class about amines, and in second properties of amines and diazonium salts. I hope you understand this clearly. Try to make practice. बहुत बार memorize कीजिए बेटा. Okay ना? Good.